Today's fountain pen is an Onoto made in England. We see the name there, Onoto the pen, De La Rue, London, number 50. The pen is in very good shape actually. It's even got the original fine nib marker on it, so I don't know whether the pen has ever been used or not. We won't know till we open it up. Looks like there's been someone's done a little bit of polishing there. Yeah, they've been polishing that with something, brasso or silvo or something by the look of it. Right, we'll undo the pen. Now the barrel and the cap, of course, made of celluloid. About 1942. Certainly seems to be in good shape. The nib. We'll get a close up on the nib. Ladder feed on it. Looking pretty clean, actually. There's a little bit of gunk on it, but it says De La Rue Onoto 14K London. Hardly a mark on it, but we'll discover that as we get further into it. Because it's very old, the pen, it's about 80 years old, and the celluloid gets very, very brittle over time. Removing the section with the nib and the feed, I'll put a piece of rubber over the case and hold it relatively tightly, so we don't exert any undue pressure on it. It is coming out, but very, very slowly. We'll get another strip of rubber. I think that the section is turning, or my gloves are spinning on the section, so we'll try that, see how we go. Very tight. All right, we'll put that into the ultrasonic and loosen it up, then we'll try it again. Right, we've got the ultrasonic set up here. I'll turn it on and we'll place the section and the top piece of the barrel into the ultrasonic and see if we can loosen it up a bit. Turn it on. I'll hold that while it's in there. Tiny little bit of stuff coming out of the thread on the end of the section, not much. No ink coming out of the nib or the feed. Certainly seems to be very clean. I'll give that another minute, then we'll take it out and we'll try it again. Okay, time's up. Take the pen out of the ultrasonic, dry it. Put the top of on the cleaner, put it over there. We'll now have a look and see if we can remove the section. Yeah, loosening up now very slowly so we don't damage it. Out it comes. We'll put that back into the ultrasonic and clean top of the barrel. It's got a bit of gunk in it. There's our section with the nib and the feed in it. I'll pop that into the ultrasonic for 3 minutes and loosen it up a bit, and then we'll take them apart. Relatively clean in there, but there's a little bit of junk. I'll put the bottle brush in, turn it round and see if we can remove that. Yep, that looks a lot better. There's certainly no ink coming out of the feed, that's for sure. Okay, time's up. I'll remove the section. We'll dry it off. Then we'll see if we can move it through the knockout block. If it's still pretty tight, then we'll put it back into the ultrasonic and do it again. See what size we want. That one there. Select the rod that's a little bit smaller. That's pretty close, gee. To be careful with that. Okay, we start off with a very light tap. See if we can move. There we go, it's coming out nicely. Moving down. I'll continue that. Very gently tapping. See the nib is coming out now. See if we can. Here we go. That's got him. There's the section. That's the feed. That's called a ladder feed for obvious reasons. That's pretty clean, little bit of muck in it, but not much. There is our 14 carat nib, which we shall clean and check before we put it back into the pen. Right, put these away. Don't want the hammer anymore. I'll remove the ultrasonic cleaner, then we'll come back, we'll look at the feed and clean that up, and then we'll look at the nib.